Raman S. He completed his undergraduate studies from Tyagarajar College of Engineering. He pursued architecture with almost 5 years of practice and allied 3 years of professional architectural photography. He worked as an architect for Studio Kriya Architects Private Limited, which is a part of TVH Housing, Chennai. And he also worked for the architectural design group, ADG, headed by A.R. Dhanasekaran, Chennai. He's also worked for many other organizations like Design Cube Architects, Carvin Design Consultants, and AIM Associates previously.
Welcome to UGC lecture series BARC. This is Building Materials 4, AR6404. So, we'll be looking at the fifth unit, the other materials essentially other than steel and steel alloys. So, we'll be looking at CGI sheets, PTFE roofing, PC roofing, flooring materials and sealants. What we'll be doing primarily is looking at direct applications of any of these materials on building construction, and then we'll look at what this material is made of, and then we'll probably look at the various advantages and the application it has in the present building construction industry. So, we'll start with CGI. CGI is nothing but corrugated galvanized iron sheets. So, if you look at this image, it's actually a hut basically. It's made completely of galvanized iron, corrugated galvanized iron, and we'll have a look at the history or the background of this. So, this hut that you saw was actually a metal hut, and it's called as the Nissen hut. It was very popular during the Second World War as a means of very cheap housing. So, a Nissen hut is a prefabricated steel structure made from a half cylindrical skin of corrugated steel, originally designed during the First World War by the engineer and inventor Major Peter Norman Nissen. It was used extensively during the Second World War. So, when you look at CGI, CGI, as I said, was corrugated galvanized iron sheets. So, you have galvanized iron, a form of iron which is coated by galvanizing it with zinc, and then you make it corrugated. So, corrugated is a process of making it rolled and textured such that it can be used more extensively. So, the Nissen hut was directly made from CGI sheets. So, Nissen, a mining engineer and inventor, constructed 3 prototype semi-cylindrical huts. So, that is how he started the experiment of constructing huts which are like semi-cylindrical shape. So, the semi-cylindrical shape was derived from the drill shed at Queen's University, Kingston, Ontario. So, it was inspired from somewhere else, but the material was what made it really famous. 2 factors influenced the design of the hut. First, the building had to be economical in its use of materials, especially considering wartime shortages of building material. Secondly, the building had to be portable. So, you notice how this particular material has become really famous and used extensively. It was really cheap and it was very portable. This was something very essential and very required of during the World War times. So, at such a time, corrugated CGI sheets were very useful, and that is how they became famous. We also look at another interesting example of how corrugated galvanized iron sheets were used. So, it is called as the tin tabernacle. Tabernacle is nothing but a religious space. So, when we look at these examples, we will see what made this particular material famous and how it was used and how it became popular. So, a tin tabernacle is a type of prefabricated ecclesiastical building made from corrugated galvanized iron. So, again, so being a religious space, a religious building, prior to this, religious buildings were made grandly with either stone or such materials that added to its grandeur as such. But here comes the use of galvanized iron, which made it really cheap and thus extended the application of churches and religious spaces to various places like village and remote areas, which is why it made it very famous and also very economically viable. So, the technology for producing the corrugated sheets improved, and to prevent corrosion, the sheets were galvanized with a coating of zinc. So, yeah, corrugated sheets were present. The galvanization process was done so that it could enhance the properties of its material. Churches, chapels, mission halls were built in new industrial areas, pit villages, near railway works, and in more isolated rural and coastal locations. So, corrugated GI sheets, being very economical, being very portable, being easily available and probably easy to make, was made available to anyone and any place like remote locations. So, several tin tabernacles survive as places of worship. Some have listed building status and some have been converted to other uses. So, you can see, apart from being very cheap and apart from being very portable and available, it has stood the test of time. So, it is very durable as such. So, what are CGI sheets essentially? So, galvanized iron sheets are steel sheets which are basically coated with zinc and include a range of hot dip galvanized and electro galvanized steel sheets. So, you have steel, it is made into sheet, drawn into sheets, and zinc is added to enhance its properties. So, zinc weathers at a very slow rate, so the coating generally has a long life. So, this is the purpose of adding zinc to it, and this is what enhances the material, the galvanized iron. Zinc has a greater electronegativity than iron and hence provides cathodic or sacrificial protection to the steel. So, the process of galvanizing steel sheet was developed simultaneously in France and England. So, this was a process that was developed simultaneously in two different parts, and it was also used extensively in various occasions. So, both these methods employed a hot dipping process. So, you have steel, you essentially dip it into hot zinc, which makes it corrugated galvanized iron. So, today the corrugation process is carried out using the process of roll forming. Even though the process of making corrugated iron has changed, it still has the same properties and is being used extensively. So, some applications we will be looking at in terms of galvanized iron sheets. Agriculture, so grain, silos, sprayers, pans and feeding troughs, etc. With agriculture, the spaces that were used had to be weathered after a point. So, an agriculturist essentially builds a space. What happens is after a certain process of weathering, the space had to be rebuilt or redone. With the invention of corrugated galvanized iron sheets, this was gradually and very extensively reduced because it became a very durable material. Automobile sector, car, bus, truck bodies, undercarriage works, air and oil filters, fuel and oil tanks, exhaust pipes. The uses of galvanized iron in automobile are various. Construction, coming to the more relevant part, roofing, sidewalls, partitions, panels, valley gutters, louvers, and endless amounts of occasions where you could use corrugated iron. So, you notice corrugated iron in lot of applications where it is necessary to be cost effective or very cost cutting. So, you see in very cheap housing forms, in group housing, or in places where you have to cover temporary spaces, corrugated iron sheets make very important use. Other household things like trunks, ice boxes, buckets and other uses have also been found to be made in domestic places. So, we looked at the two important examples of where GI sheets have been used, and we noticed that cost cutting, durability and easy availability was important advantages. We will also look at it again. So, galvanizing is lower in first cost than many other commonly specified protective coatings for steel. So, steel is used in many forms, various coatings are applied, but galvanizing it seems to be the most cheaply available first cost that is applied to steel. So, less maintenance costs. So, for any building material or any construction material for that matter, the sheets have to have very low maintenance after it has been installed. So, CGI offers that in a very great extent. Long life, as I said, those buildings are even registered today in building usage. So, the life expectancy of GI sheets is quite high in rural, urban and coastal environments. Reliability. So, galvanizing is usually carried out as per standard and minimum coating thicknesses are applied. So, having it in a very prototypical form makes it very reliable in terms as a building material. So, toughest coating, adding a few more layers of coating makes it a very tough coating and hence more durable. So, it offers complete protection, every part of galvanized iron sheet is protected. So, when you take a building material or building material sheet for that matter, there are parts which have to be dressed differently, there are parts which have to be treated differently. But in case of CGI sheets, every part of galvanized iron is already protected, so you do not have to add extensive measures. Galvanizing process is not dependent on weather conditions. So, like in the case of concrete or iron where curing is an important part of the finishing method, galvanized iron does not depend on weathering conditions or such delays. With that, we come to an end with CGI sheets. We will move on to PTFE or what is called as Teflon, which is more famous. So, again we look at two important examples which use PTFE extensively. So, this is a bus shelter at Aura. You can see that the roof is completely made of a tensile fabric. So, PTFE is not essentially a building material, it is actually a fabric, but it is a tensile fabric which makes it easy to be used for roofing or such related membrane covering related construction materials. So, the Swiss city of Aura, a cantonal capital, has gained its own cloud in the shape of an organically formed bus station canopy with a reflective and semi-translucent skin. So, as I list out the various design features of these projects, you will notice the important features which happen to be the advantages of these materials. So, in this case, it is a reflective and semi-translucent skin. A 120 meter long polythene tubes under the road supply the pneumatic air cushion with recirculated clean dry air, and another 4 tubes take the air back. So, what happens is there is a skeletal framework of polyethylene tubes between which this translucent layer of material is added. So, both the cushion and tubing are more or less airtight. The roof is highly economical to operate. So, you notice it is reflective, it is semi-translucent. Now, it adds the feature of it being very lightweight, and also it is very economical to operate. Supported by a steel cable, the transparent canopy is made from an upper blue and lower clear PTFE foil. So, it is made of two layers of PTFE foil, which is the material we are talking about, sprinted with a bubble pattern that together creates a sinuously formed airtight cushion. So, you notice that in many materials there are air entrapments which happen to make it a very weak material, but in this case there is air tightness as well. Also, you can create patterns on the material which is not available for every other material. So, as I said, it is also airtight, so reduces a lot of other problems. Here we look at another large scale project. This is actually a design office of a fashion brand in China by an architect called MAD. So, MAD architects have conceived a new design center for international fashion group Sini in the coastal Chinese city of Xiamen. So, they have described the design as a star shaped layout that formalizes a solid bone structure frame. So, what they are trying to do is they have a basic structure, a basic set of buildings, and what they have done is they have covered it with a structural frame. Apart from that, they have also covered it with a membrane to make it look very transparent and lightweight. So, a translucent layer of PTFE plastic will be draped around the outside, allowing light to enter and creating wide views out for the staff. So, we looked at it being very reflective, semi-translucent. It is very light in weight, it has airtight features. Apart from that, it is also allowing light, makes it, gives it a light feeling to the whole thing, and also lets light come in as a building material. This is very important. So, according to MAD, this delicate sunshading skin will make the 8-story building look elegant and floating. So, this is an added aesthetic value for the building, which is allowed by PTFE. So, PTFE, Teflon, both are one and the same thing. So, Teflon is a registered trade name of the highly useful plastic material polytetrafluoroethylene. So, PTFE as it is shortly called. So, you have heard of Teflon very famously. Teflon is used in coating cookware. You have Teflon pans and Teflon cooking utensils. So, that is how it is famous. So, a reason why it is famous in cooking is that it has very low friction. So, that also makes it a valuable material in terms of construction as well as for cooking and domestic purposes. So, many common synthetic fibers are polymers such as polyester and nylon. So, similarly, PTFE is also a common synthetic fiber. So, PTFE has many unique properties which make it valuable in scores of applications. It has a very high melting point. It is stable at low temperatures, extremely resistant to corrosion. It is also very slick and slippery, as I said, a very low friction level. This makes it an excellent material for coating machine parts as well. So, wherever friction is required, wherever there is meeting of two building materials or wherever two materials for that matter, PTFE makes for an excellent use. So, these are subjected to heat, wear, friction and laboratory equipment which must resist corrosive chemicals. So, it also has its application in labs. So, we look at properties directly now. It is weather and UV resistant, which is very important for a building material. It has excellent optical properties. As I said, it could let in light. So, it has a semi-translucent property. It has a non-stick surface which we have discussed. Very few solid substances can permanently stick to a Teflon coating. So, when you coat a particular surface with Teflon, there are very, very few materials that can stick to it as such. So, you can imagine it being used in places where there are a lot of wear and tear. So, it has outstanding performance at extreme temperature. It has low coefficient of friction. Thus, there is no difficulty in sliding one surface against another. This is where its application in machine parts come. So, Teflon finishes are both hydrophobic and oleophobic. So, hydrophobic means it has nothing to do with water. So, any amount of water does not affect it, which makes it an excellent material in terms of building materials. So, which makes cleanup easier and more thorough. So, it is also easy to maintain. We will look at applications. We looked at the two important buildings that applied PTFE directly to their buildings. So, PTFE is an incredibly versatile material used across many industries thanks to its stable and durable characteristics. So, one of the most affordable fluoropolymers. So, there are many polymers which can be used in building construction as well as tensile fabrics, but this happens to be the most affordable. It is often used in construction projects for structures as car parks, supermarkets and bridges. So, spaces that need semi-transparent or a semi-private area of roofing or covering, PTFE has a direct application. So, plus its resistance against weather damage and general wear and tear make it an extremely long-lasting material. So, we discussed its properties of having extreme durability and long life. So, that makes it a very long-lasting material. So, PTFE is perhaps best known for its use as a non-stick coating for cookware. So, even though it has a lot of uses in building technology and also machine technology and automobiles, it is most famous for its use in cookware technology. So we'll now move on to next type of roofing material. This is polycarbonate sheets, simply called as PC sheets. Again, look at two projects which make direct use of PC sheets. So this is a house of two scene. The translucent polycarbonate walls of this house in Hiroshima by Japanese architect's supposed design office allow natural light to flood the interior from all sides. So what happens is the architects were proposed with a design to be designed in a space which is closely packed by two other sides. So they used PC sheets directly because it was very easy to allow light to come in and make it a very airy and lively place. So it allows natural light to flood the interior from all sides. The three-story building was designed by supposed design architects as the residence of a family of five, who also requested a space for storing and repairing of collection of motorcycles. So you see, it could be applied to any residential matter. So it is surrounded on three sides by neighboring buildings. So the architects added translucent cladding to allow light to permeate the interior without compromising residents' privacy. So what they did was they had to allow light in and give a lot of airy space in the whole building. So PC sheets was helpful in achieving this effect. So we used a thin translucent material to replace the regular exterior walls where natural light can be maximized in the interior space. So you notice that it could bring in light completely because of its translucent nature. We look at another large scale project. This is a sports hall by architects BCQ. So if you look at the picture, you can see the same translucent material being used. It gives you a very light and airy feeling, allows light inside, and you can also have a semi private way of looking at what happens inside. So Barcelona Studio BCQ chose translucent plastic panels for the house of for the walls of the municipal sports hall in Spain, giving the building an ethereal quality that helps it match the colors of the sky. So apart from being a durable material, a lightweight material, it was giving an added value to the aesthetic appeal. So located in Olot in the municipality of Girona, the sports hall was designed by BCQ as a simple and visually lightweight addition to its site in a green space along one of the city's tree lined avenues. So in a space where there was nature and it was endowed with nature, a lightweight addition was very essential, and the use of PC sheets was able to help with that. A strip of glazing running around the base of the hall creates the impression that the main structure is raised above the ground. So again, the lightweight feature, it being enhanced. These windows offer a glimpse of activities that take place inside. So we looked at two important projects. We look at what PC sheets are essentially. So polycarbonate plastics are naturally transparent, amorphous, thermoplastic. So with respect to plastic, there are thermoplastic and thermostatic plastics. You can compare thermostatic thermoplastic to that of butter. You could heat butter, it could melt, and it can then reform its solid place. But with the case of thermosetting plastic, this is not possible. Once converted into liquid, it cannot be reconverted into a solid. So now polycarbonate is nothing but a thermoplastic. So it can be heated to form a liquid and then again form back into a solid, which is a peculiar feature. Although they are made commercially available in a variety of colors, the raw material allows for internal transmission of light nearly in the same capacity as glass. So it is a great alternative for the use of glass in many spaces. So it's being replacing glass as it allows light as much as glass. So polycarbonate polymers are used to produce a variety of materials and are particularly useful when impact resistance or transparency are a product requirement. So apart from it replacing glass, it has this added value of it being wear resistant or tear resistant. So it can handle any amount of impact resistance, or it can handle wind or storms for that matter. So PC is commonly used for plastic lenses and eyewear. So making it very impact resistant has its application in optometrics too. So other than that, it has some interesting applications in the case of protective gear, greenhouses or houses which have applications for plants use a lot of polycarbonate sheeting. Digital discs, CDs, DVDs, Blu-ray disc, anything can be used, is made from polycarbonate, and exterior lighting fixtures are made from polycarbonate. So polycarbonate also has very good heat resistance and can be combined with flame retardant materials. So in itself, PC is a very flame retardant material. So when you combine it with other flame retardant materials, it makes it a very fireproof material without significant material gradation. So PC is classified as a thermoplastic, as I mentioned, and the name has to do with the way the plastic responds to heat. So as I said, it responds to heat in a way, and it can be formed back into a solid, which becomes an important feature. They possess desirable features such as lightweight, high impact strength, UV protection, and better aesthetic value. So this becomes an important reason of use in both residential as well as large scale uses, can be used reliably. So polycarbonate panels can withstand force and are virtually unbreakable. That is why they are used in the construction of bulletproof police shields. So when you've looked at riots or police trying to cops trying to prevent riots happening, you notice that they hold shields, and these shields are particularly very transparent or translucent for that matter. So these are nothing but made of polycarbonate sheeting. So you have a direct application of its impact resistance and how it's unbreakable. So these panels are resistant to heat, sunlight, snow and rain, which enable them to last for many years without fading or discoloring. So this is another added feature. So polycarbonate is most extensively used in building construction in the form of roofing. So it's a lightweight thermoplastic material that is known for its ability to withstand extreme hot and cold temperatures. So its durability, its reliability makes it a very ideal material for the use of roofing. So while this material is not used to cover an entire home, polycarbonate can be used to cover patios, desks and conservatories. So the greenhouses or conservatories can have its application PCs. So even though PC cannot be used for the complete main roofing of a particular building, it can be used for the temporary decks and patios. So these panels are available in a number of shades including white and smoky gray. They are often used in places where natural sunlight still needs to be able to get through. So letting in light is an important feature. These panels usually have a film applied that reflects harmful UV light from being able to enter into the structure. In addition to being able to withstand extreme temperature, they are extremely durable. So PPGI sheets are nothing but pre-coated galvanized iron sheets. So what happens is there are galvanized iron sheets. After its production, they are usually painted. But in this case, it's pre-painted during its production, which makes it a particular feature and has its particular applications. So PPGI refers to factory pre-painted zinc coated steel, where the steel is painted before forming as opposed to post-painting, which occurs after forming. The term is an extension of GI, which is the traditional abbreviation for galvanized iron. So the hot dip metallic coating process is also used to manufacture steel sheet. So the steel thus produced is pre-painted, pre-finished and ready for use. So that is an important added feature of PPGI sheets. So we'll now move on to other materials that are used for flooring finishes. So in this image, you can see that there are four different types of flooring. One is carpet, the other is PVC, then there's epoxy flooring, and then there's industrial hardeners. So we'll start with epoxy flooring. It's the toughest and most durable finish. So an epoxy garage floor coating is not paint. So you notice that epoxy flooring is used for garages or places where there's hard wear and tear or high traffic. So paint for garage floors is a less latex acrylic product. So when you use paint or such things, it is not essentially able to handle that much traffic or wear and tear. So epoxy is an actual thermosetting resin that is applied as a coating. So epoxy is not necessarily a paint, it's actually a protective coating. It is formed when you mix one part epoxide resin with one part polyamine hardener. So basically what they do is they harden the surface and make it viable for high traffic and high wear and tear. So unlike paint, this has to be dry and epoxy cures. So what you do is when you paint a surface, you have to wait for it to dry, but in the case of epoxy, it actually cures. So it makes it a more viable hardening element. So besides looking nice in polish, the hardened and thickened application that you get from epoxy creates a coating that is very durable. It's resilient to impacts, chipping, chemical stains and surface abrasion. So you can attribute all these requirements of high wear and tear to that of industrial areas, to that of high traffic areas like public use buildings, etc., hospitals as well. So the thicker coating also does a great job of covering over minor imperfections such as small spider cracks and fall and flaws in the concrete. So it makes up for the concrete disadvantages as floorings, and when you add epoxy flooring coating, it makes up for all those flaws. So because epoxy is a topical sealer, it is also anti-dusting. So dust is an important element or a problem as far as flooring is concerned. Where as far as epoxy is concerned, dusting is highly reduced or gradually made nil. So normal traffic on bare concrete can kick up the dusty powder that has a tendency of collecting on cars as well as being tracked into the house. So this is reduced to a great extent. So it is also naturally moisture resistant. So besides that, it can create an easy, clean, seamless surface. So for any surface or any flooring, maintenance or cleaning is an important aspect to be considered, and epoxy makes it very easy to be maintained. It offers an environmentally friendly flooring solution. So in present day, sustainability and making a material being very environment friendly is an important feature. So epoxy has that feature in it. So they're very environment friendly solutions for those interested in choosing green alternates and building materials. So now we move on to industrial flooring hardeners. So as the name implies, these are especially required or applied in industrial flooring. Oxychloride flooring hardener is ideal for heavy duty machinery movements. It has excellent load bearing capacity. So while a coating or a floor finish can have various features, a load bearing is a very important feature as far as industrial applications are concerned. This can be laid on any sound surface like concrete, metal and wooden floor. So it's basically a coating, not a complete flooring material in itself. It is long lasting and helps to overcome many problems day to day faced in the industry. So the main problems faced in industry are wear and tear and high impact and high traffic. So used in most industrial flooring for its high and heavy traffic, these hardeners enhance the flooring, which comprise the following characteristics. So it withstands heavy traffic movements. It is excellent load bearing. It does not generate dust or cracks as cement based floors. It's ready to use after 24 hours for manual traffic. So compared to other materials which have to be done over a period of days or weeks, this requires only 24 hours for finishing. We now move on to PVC tiling. So PVC is nothing but vinyl tiling. So is a finished floor material used primarily in commercial and institutional applications. So you take any public use building as far as hospitals, schools, anything that requires very low cost and very durable material floor finishing, PVC will be found. So modern vinyl flooring tiles and sheet flooring and version of those products sold since the early 1980s are composed of colored polyvinyl chloride chips formed into solid sheets of varying thickness. So that's how that is formed and is used. So modern vinyl flooring tile is frequently chosen for high traffic areas because of its low cost, durability and ease of maintenance as I mentioned before. So vinyl tiles have high resilience to abrasion and impact damage and can be repeatedly refinished with chemical strippers and mechanical buffing equipment. So another important advantage with vinyl flooring is in case of damage it can be replaced immediately because it is basically finished easily and has buffed. So all you have to do is remove it and replace it with another tile. So if properly installed, tiles can be easily removed and replaced when damaged, as I mentioned. So the advantages of PVC tiling: slightly softer surface than options like tile or wood. So wood and tile have a direct reaction to impact. So vinyl being a very rather soft flooring when compared to wood or tile makes it very viable in terms of impact resistance. So vinyl tiles are available in a huge assortment of colors and styles. Vinyl also wears incredibly well, so makes it a long lasting equipment. It is extremely durable. Vinyl flooring is very resistant to dirt and water, so it makes it very easy to maintain. As far as cleaning and maintenance goes, vinyl is hard to beat. So it's the most easy to maintain and most easy to be clean material to be found in terms of floor finishes. So requiring practically no maintenance after installation, vinyl needs to just be swept and mopped occasionally to keep the floor clean. So for any building material as well as a floor finish, its maintenance after installation is a very important feature. So as far as vinyl is concerned, that is very easy to maintain. So we now move on to carpets, another flooring finish. So carpet, you've heard of it from very long time. It has various uses, various purposes, various types that are available today. But it basically started off as a floor finish or as a flooring coating between the main floor and the use impact. So carpet is a textile floor covering typically consisting of an upper layer of pile attached to a backing. So that is what a carpet is basically made of, a pile. This pile is usually made from wool, but since 20th century many polymers have also been used. So the pile usually consists of twisted tufts which are typically heat treated to maintain the structure. So this is how a carpet is made. So what a carpet does is it cuts off the direct contact from a cold tile or a cold surface of any human interface. So carpets are used for a variety of purposes, including insulation a person feeds from cold tile or concrete floor, making a room more comfortable as a place to sit on the floor, reducing sound from walking, so acoustic insulation, and adding decoration or color to a room. So apart from having these very functional purposes, it also adds to the aesthetic value. So as I said, insulation, carpet can help save energy as it is an important contributor to the insulation of the indoor environment. So adding to the insulation or heat value of a room is very important. This reduces the energy impact. So acoustics, as I said, several studies find that carpets absorb sound and carpets with padding further enhance this ability. So it also provides acoustic insulation. So it's easier to maintain because it does not have any breaking parts. You don't have to replace it because of its broken tiles, etc. So carpeting is less labor intensive to clean and maintain than hard surface flooring because of this, and as mentioned, can cost less to maintain as well. So safety, as far as other surfaces are concerned, the slip and fall accidents or any accident usually originate with carpets is very greatly reduced. We'll now move on to the final part of this lecture. We'll be talking about sealants. So the main difference between adhesives, you've heard of adhesives, and sealants is that sealants typically have lower strength and higher elongation than adhesives. So sealant have this elongation feature, which makes it an important material in terms of sealing. So when sealants are used between substrates having different thermal coefficients of expansion or differing elongation under stress, they need to have adequate flexibility and elongations. So you have sealants being used for various purposes other than just sealing in particular. Sealants generally contain inert filling material and are usually formulated with an elastomer to give the required flexibility and elongation. So they usually have a paste consistency to allow filling of gaps between substrates. So when compared to adhesives, this have a more paste kind of consistency. So many adhesive technologies can be formulated into sealants. So while adhesive can be an adhesive, it can also be a sealant, but a sealant cannot be an adhesive. Sealant is any material placed in a joint opening generally for the purpose of weatherproofing a building. So the main purpose of a sealant is to weatherproof a building so that water, air, or excessive light or UV cannot penetrate into it. So designed to prevent the passage of moisture, air, dust, and heat through all joints and seams in the structure. So sealants, despite not having great strength, convey a number of properties. They seal top structures to the substrate. They are particularly effective in waterproofing processes by keeping moisture out. They are also acoustically relevant. They can provide thermal and acoustic insulation, as I just mentioned, and may serve as fire barriers. So apart from being all these particular features, they also act as fire retardants. They may have electrical properties as well. Sealants can also be used for simple smoothing or filling. So apart from being used for weatherproofing, it can also be used just to seal two materials so that the joints are not visible. So the various applications of sealants would be horizontal and vertical, metal to metal, masonry expansion and control joints. So basically joints are an important application as far as sealants are concerned. With that, we come to the end of this lecture. So what we've learned throughout this lecture is we've got an idea of the various roofing materials that categorize as lightweight, the reasons for the development and uses. So we've looked at lightweight roofing, the lightweight materials. We had a brief look at some of the applications worldwide of the above roofing system. We looked at the basic project examples of how these materials are directly applied in terms of construction industry. Understanding the main types of flooring finishes and their application and advantage, we looked at the various flooring materials, the hardening capabilities of them, and the role of sealants and their advantages in building applications. So some exercises which you could try on your own is a listing of various types of lightweight roofing in the various structures in neighborhood, public and residential building. So you can come up with a list for that. Making case studies, of course, of various aspects of a residence and multi-use building that use light roofing systems. Case studies of flooring finishes that can be used in various residential and mixed-use buildings. List of various instances where use of sealant is required and the purpose it serves. Thank you.